The foundation of Zoom IQ for Sales is the data that you and your team members feed into it. Each conversation with a customer contains valuable insight, so let's make sure we are correctly funneling data into Zoom IQ to be analyzed. While you should have received an automated email about being assigned a license, you can verify all Zoom licenses assigned to you from your account profile page. In a web browser, navigate to zoom.us and sign in to your Zoom account. Under the Account section, you should see a Zoom IQ for Sales license assigned to you. With Zoom IQ for Sales, data is gathered in four primary ways: meetings, calendar events, phone calls, and emails. Let's explore each option. As a host or co-host in a Zoom meeting, you now have the ability to record to the cloud with Zoom IQ. At the moment, only cloud recordings can be processed by Zoom IQ. This option will be checked by default for every meeting. Any meeting recorded with Zoom IQ will be added to the queue to be analyzed and processed. That's great, but what happens if you uncheck Zoom IQ when you record? Luckily, these recordings can be added to IQ for Sales after the meeting. First, you can access your cloud recordings from the Zoom web portal. Along the left navigation, select Recordings to see all of your recorded meetings. Some recordings will have a small IQ tag next to their title. These recordings have been added to Zoom IQ already, which is fantastic. In the case of my most recent meeting, I turned Zoom IQ off. By clicking on the triple dots to the far right of a recording, I can choose to add the recording to Zoom IQ. Tucked under Advanced Search is the ability to filter your recordings to see if any other meetings need to be added to IQ for processing. At this point, it is worth taking a look at your cloud recording settings. Along the left navigation, select Settings. Then select the Recordings tab along the top. Under Cloud Recordings, there are a host of options to choose from when cloud recording is enabled. If not checked already, be sure to check the box next to Create Audio Transcript. This helps identify who is speaking in a meeting, which is very important to how Zoom IQ functions. By integrating your calendar, Zoom IQ can see who is scheduled to attend your upcoming meetings. On your Zoom profile page, scroll toward the bottom and click on Configure Calendar and Contact Service. Select which service you would like to connect and follow the various prompts. Once connected, you will see a confirmation message at the top of the window. Zoom IQ can now see who is attending your upcoming meetings, but now what? Select Settings, then select the Zoom IQ for Sales tab at the top and scroll down to the Conversations Meeting section. If this setting is enabled, meetings with external participants will be automatically recorded without any intervention on your part. For Zoom phone calls, the data gathering process is pretty straightforward. During a call, click Record. Once the call is complete, the call will be added as a conversation within Zoom IQ. Within the recorded conversation, be sure to update the deal information to tie the call to a specific customer or deal. Email is the final component to configure with Zoom IQ for Sales. Along the left navigation, select Settings. Then select the Zoom IQ for Sales tab at the top. In the Email subsection, toggle on Email Integration, then click on Configure to select your email service. Follow the prompts to complete the integration process. To recap what we've covered, you now know how to connect Zoom meetings and phone, as well as your calendar and email clients to Zoom IQ for Sales. Time to turn your conversations into actionable data.